Hello, I'm Kurt Browning, Pasco County Superintendent of Schools. I have an important message for you today regarding our reopening plan for the fall, specifically how we're going to handle masks and face coverings. First, I want to point out that every decision that we have made has been made after we received meaningful input from parents and staff. We're determined to do what is best for students, parents, and staff, and your opinions and concerns are extremely helpful in guiding our decisions. With that in mind, I'm announcing that our school district will mandate that all employees, visitors, and students wear a mask or other face covering while on school property and/or engaged in school activities. How and why have we made this decision? Over the past several weeks, parents and staff have done their research to decide which option to choose. Many had questions and concerns. We receive thousands of questions and concerns, and a great number of them involve masks and face coverings. Due to the CDC recommendations and due to the fact that infections have been on the rise, many wondered why we were not requiring masks on campus. The majority of people who weighed in regarding masks felt very strongly that we should require them. At this point, I believe everyone has weighed in. Parents, staff, the school board, health professionals, and the county commission have all weighed in. As I have said many times, the health and well-being of our students and staff is our highest priority. Of course, not everyone agrees. This requirement will upset some parents. I understand that, but we heard from them too. But we have a responsibility to protect our students and staff and the community. We as a school district have a unique responsibility and a unique opportunity to help halt the spread of COVID-19 and to help our community get back to something a bit more normal. I will take this to the school board as an emergency rule. We have provided more detail on our reopening webpage, and I urge you to look it over. That's where you'll find details about exactly what our expectations are and what this will look like on a day-to-day basis in our schools. The emergency rule explains what qualifies as an appropriate mask or face covering. It also explains that we do not expect all students and staff to wear masks or face coverings all day. The emergency rule provides guidance so that students and staff can take a break from the mask when they are eating lunch or at other times, so long as they are carefully exercising safe social distancing. And we are aware that some students and employees have medical conditions that affect their ability to wear a mask. Those requests will be handled sensitively and appropriately. So, I urge you to look over the proposed emergency rule. It provides flexibility so we can adjust and perhaps relax the rule based on prevailing conditions. I believe it is an important and essential addition to our plan for successfully reopening our schools in the fall. Thank you.